Now, had he lived, Elvis would be celebrating his 58th birthday today. And to commemorate the occasion, the post office has been issuing the famed Elvis stamp. The Mexican imitator Elvis was among the dozens of fans who showed up at the Hollywood post office as the first Elvis stamp went on sale. They say he may be gone, but not forgotten.
Birthday, dear Elvis! Happy birthday to you!
And at the airport, Elvis is everywhere, in the cockpit of a jet and packed in from one end of the terminal to the other. They're all winners of a radio promotion, and they were all on their way to Las Vegas to perform at the Golden Nugget Hotel. Naturally, they broke into song.
Honeymoon in Vegas.
That's what it was, right.
It's just like, well, there was a big turnout at Graceland today to celebrate the King's 58th birthday anniversary and, of course, the first sale of the Elvis Presley Memorial Stamp. To the sound of music and the glare of fireworks over the Presley Mansion, the Elvis commemorative stamps went on sale. Thousands had to brave a cold rain to be among the first to buy the new issue. The Postmaster General was there, too. He presented Presley's daughter, Lisa, with a special sheet of the stamps.
It's a great acknowledgement, and I really appreciate it. And I speak on behalf of him and my family and myself. Thank you.
And as we've been saying, sales of the Presley stamp started at noon in other parts of the country. Response pretty phenomenal. Pretty phenomenal indeed.
Boy, the resemblance between Lisa and her father is
phenomenal. She has dad's look, hasn't
she? Amazing. All right, that's it for us at 4. Thanks for joining us. The news continues now. Here's Paul.
Everybody's been having fun with us today. You know, there's been another Elvis sighting. This time, the King's been spotted at the post office. I'm sure by now you must have heard the official Elvis stamp made its debut today. Action News has the story. Live on the scene with Fred Villanueva. Fred.
Chris, if you're an Elvis Presley fan, no longer is your collection complete with just Elvis's music. As of today, you also need the much-anticipated Elvis stamp.
Return to sender, address unknown, no such number, no such soul.
Could it be? Could Elvis have known something over 30 years ago when he wrote this song? 500 million Elvis stamps are being printed, the largest ever special issue. Elvis, no longer just the king of rock and roll, he's also the king of the 29-cent stamp. In Memphis, they waited in the rain, some for over 12 hours, for the post office to open just past midnight on what would have been his 58th birthday. And they came from all over the world.
Elvis is a tops in Scotland.
In County Armagh, Northern Ireland.
The first stamp went to Lisa Marie, the unmistakable daughter of Elvis. Highlighting the Memphis event was this fireworks display over Graceland, the longtime Presley home. Other parts of the country had to wait until noon local time to make the stamps available. Here in Hollywood, the cult figure Elvis, the Mexican Elvis, was understandably the first in line.
But now he was sanctified by the U.S. government by having his own official stamp. This means he's officially part of American culture, a stronghold, a pillar of society, because, you know, he licked the back of his head.
Elvis promptly placed the stamp on a letter to President-elect Bill Clinton. There was also an impromptu celebration on Elvis's star on Hollywood Boulevard. Elvis appeared in 30 movies during his career. Even former President Richard Nixon got into the act. Nixon happens to celebrate his birthday on the same day as Elvis. And today, postcards went on sale showing the president and the king shaking hands. An estimated 350 people packed into the former president's Yorba Linda library to buy these cards with canceled stamps. Some of these people waited 5 hours.
There's only one king and only one Nixon. And when they're together, how can you beat it? What a team.
And by the way, if you never got the word, the younger Elvis stamp won out over the older Elvis stamp by a margin of about 3-1. Chris?
We may be waiting for that Nixon stamp for quite a while. What is this costing the post office, by the way?
I don't know exactly what it's costing, but the estimate on the profit is about $20 million, so the post office is turning a profit on this one.
So they're making money. All right, Fred, thank you.
Can you think of two more different personalities than Elvis Presley and Richard Nixon? Take it one step further and compare Graceland to the Nixon Library in Yorba Linda. Well, Mark Brown shows us there is a timely link between Presley and Nixon.
Graceland, Elvis Presley's birthplace, is ordinarily a crowded place on the late singer's birthday. Today, it was even more so. The stamp bearing his likeness went on sale today a little after midnight. Thousands of fans braved a cold Memphis rain to pick up the stamps at special mobile post offices set up just for that purpose.
If you would form your line around there, we will start selling at 12 noon.
This is a long way from Graceland, Yorba Linda, the birthplace of former President Richard Nixon. 17 years after Nixon's resignation and 15 years after Presley's death, the two together are turning out to be a big attraction, all because of this photo taken in 1970 of Presley and Nixon together in the Oval Office, a meeting commemorated in special edition postcards with the Elvis Presley stamp attached.
I would like a half dozen of this one and a half dozen of the other one.
After waiting hours for her postcards, Joyce Lindrum's sailor finally got them.
Do you wonder whether Richard Nixon maybe in the White House might have grooved to a little Jailhouse Rock every now and then?
Oh, of course. I can see it.
We don't know whether Nixon is a fan. In a videotaped statement, he described Presley as flamboyant.
But as I talked to him, I sensed, too, that basically he's a very shy man. Flamboyance was covering up the shyness.
There was no covering up the enthusiasm of the folks who came to have their picture taken with the famous pair.
Now I got something to brag about. I met both these guys, even though they were cardboard.
You know, from the size of the crowd that's here, you'd think Richard Nixon and Elvis Presley were actually here. But today, cardboard cutouts will suffice. It's clear that both men still have legions of fans. In Yorba Linda, with the President and the King, Mark Brown, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Dick, Mark, and Elvis. I kind of like it. Crosby, Stills, and Nash, and now we have those three. Well,
yes.
Maybe not.
Pasando a otro tema, Elvis Presley vuelve a causar furor en todo el país. No, no se trata de uno de sus reportados avistamientos, sino de la puesta a la venta de la tan esperada estampilla en su honor. Desde Los Ángeles, Vicky Gutiérrez nos habla de la locura por el rey del rock and roll.
It's Imitar al rey de la música rock no es cosa fácil. Aparte de portar un vestuario multicolor, hay que saber cantar y saber moverse como él.
Pero siempre me han dicho que me parecía, entonces hasta mi madre me dijo que Elvis es mi padre, entonces quién sabe. No.
El espíritu de Elvis se dejó sentir hoy en el Aeropuerto Internacional de Los Ángeles, donde 58 de sus más apasionados seguidores le conmemoraron hoy en su aniversario.
Van a tener un contest, ¿cómo se dice? Van a tener un contesto y el que gana va a ganar $1,000.
Todo este auge llamó la atención de mucha gente también.
Hay un chino, un mexicano. Realmente son pocos los que se parecen.
Cuando estamos entrando en la escalera, vimos como 10 Elvis. Y mi esposa me cogió y mire, Elvis, Elvis. Y me cogió mi cámara y salió y tomó fotos de Elvis.
Mientras tanto, en el corazón de Hollywood se vendía el primer timbre postal con la fotografía del inmortal cantante. Nada menos que al fanático número uno de Elvis, Elvis.
Hoy es la fiesta, es el cumpleaños, las mañanitas de Elvis, el rey. Hoy es el primer día de la estampilla de Elvis.
Desde muy temprano, a través de todo el país, se formaban largas filas de gente para comprar la famosa estampilla.
Quiero adquirir para probablemente coleccionarlo, tal vez suba de valor, es algo importante para tener.
¿Cuántas va a comprar?
500 estampillas.
Y dice el dicho que cada cabeza es un mundo, y este es el mundo de todos los que aman a Elvis Presley. Desde Hollywood, Vicky Gutiérrez, Univision.
El Departamento de Servicios Postales imprimió dos veces más que cualquier estampilla conmemorativa. Un total de 300 millones están a la venta.
Just ahead, there were big doings all across the country today as Elvis fans line up for the first chance to get a stamp honoring their hero.
Kiss me, my darling, be mine tonight.
For the king of rock and roll's 58th birthday, the Elvis Presley commemorative stamp has finally become available. A series of bizarre events took place all over the country to celebrate both the stamp's debut and Elvis's birthday. Our Francesca has a roundup.
Return the sender.
Thousands of fans made a pilgrimage to Graceland and braved the rain so they could buy their stamps today. Priscilla Presley said a few words, followed by Elvis's only daughter, Lisa Marie.
I'm very honored. Thank you very much.
Local locally, these people lined up at the Nixon Library in Yorba Linda for their stamps. President Nixon and Elvis share the same birthday. And radio station Kiss FM recruited a plane load of flying Elvises for a trip to Las Vegas for the King's birthday.
It's now or never, my love won't wait.
I'm gonna faint, man.
At a Los Angeles post office, the Popinjays, an alternative band from England, performed acoustically with their friend Peter Tork of the Monkees. The Popinjays recently had a hit in the UK with a song called Vote for Elvis.
We like the concept of Elvis rather than Elvis. Just how so many people get so excited by one person and what he was, he was a musician, you know, and that's really brilliant.
It's a big day for Elvis and the post office. The 500 million stamps that have been printed, plus all of the related memorabilia, are expected to raise $20 million in profit for the Postal Service.
Within the next week, Los Angeles is supposed to have about 2.5 million, and I hope we sell every one of them.
Elvis fans lobbied for 9 years to get a commemorative stamp of their rock hero, and today their dream became a reality. Francesca Cappucci, Channel 7 Eyewitness News in Los Angeles.
Thank you, Francesca. And Elvis truly has left the post office.
Finally.
Finally. That's Eyewitness News for now. Thank you for watching, and have a safe weekend.
Return the sender. Return the sender.
I gave a letter to the postman. He put it in his sack. Bright and early next morning, he brought my letter back.
She wrote upon it, return the sender. Address unknown. No such number, no such song. We had a quarrel, a lover's spat.
All right, I'm sorry, but my letter keeps coming back. So then I dropped it in the mailbox as in a special deed. Bright and early next morning, it came right back to me.
She wrote upon it, return the sender, address unknown. No such person, no such soul.
This time I'm gonna take it myself and put it right in her hand.
Oh, boy, to get a letter with an Elvis stamp.
Just a 29-cent stamp.
We've been instructed everybody to, when they receive their letter, to be sure and keep it.
Yeah, right, just a stamp.
The Elvis stamp tattoo right there, ladies and gentlemen. Look at those goosebumps showing her excitement.
The way Elvis was just an entertainer.
If you love Elvis as much as I do, you'll do anything for him.
I want you, I need you, I love you.
What kind of people stand out in the rain for 12 hours, like they did at Graceland last night, just to buy stamps?
That face,
yeah.
The music, those lips.
The kind of people who talk about Elvis as if he were still alive.
I don't just love Elvis for how he sings. I love Elvis because I know he's very generous.
Well, I say, tell me, baby, what's wrong with you?
You have to be dead to get your picture on a stamp. But 15 years after his death, Elvis is still bigger than life.
When I got to the checkout lane, Elvis was standing right there.
More for some people than others.
How much does he weigh now?
Oh, he's a slim gent.
A psychic in New York tried to contact him today. Oh. There was a rash of Elvis sightings all over the country.
You ain't nothing but hound dog.
Graceland may be Elvis Central, but Elvites are a worldwide phenomenon.
From Spain,
I'm from France,
from Germany.
And given sales of the new stamp, the king will soon surround us all.
New stamps typically come out in editions of about 150 million, but there isn't anything typical about Elvis. Postal officials all shook up with glee over advanced orders, which are unlike anything they've ever seen, have printed up 500 million stamps, the most ever.
That's a lot of Elvis sightings.
I find it all so amusing.
Coming soon to a mailbox near you. Reed Galen, CBS News, Graceland.
buses around the nation as the official Elvis stamp went on sale. This is the only day Elvis would have turned, he would have turned 58 on this day, I should say. In his honor, there was a stampede outside Graceland, where the first stamps went on sale at midnight. Diehard fans waited in line for hours. Lines were also long at King's birthplace in Tupelo, Mississippi.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't never got a rap. You ain't no friend of mine.
If he ain't got it, he'll get it. The Postal Service plans to sell 500 million Elvis stamps while they're about.
He sure was moving like him.
Oh, my.
Well, that's the news at this hour. Oh. But there's a lot more ahead on Prime 9 News. For some stars, even a widescreen TV is just too small. Elvis Presley is one of them, though he's been gone for more than 15 years now. Today was his birthday and your first chance to get the Elvis stamp. Here's Nancy Williams with her 29 cents worth.
The only place you're going to see the king is on a 29 cent stamp.
Elvis impersonator Danny Yu has written a song to commemorate the new Elvis stamp and to put to rest once and for all any rumors the king is still alive.
You'll see me on the back of a mail pack sack. So you'll see me on your door and at your favorite store. Something like that. Rock and mail will travel through
sleet and snow. If you question just how serious Danny Yu really is about Elvis Presley, there are a few other small clues, like he's building a house that's a virtual replica of Graceland. Danny's Graceland is called Melody Land. He's been working on the 8,000 square foot mansion for 2 years. He'll move in this spring. Not to be outdone, Elvez, the man who calls himself the Mexican Elvis, bought and mailed the first letter with an Elvis stamp in Hollywood today and cut the Elvis birthday cake.
All the clerks have Elvis stamps. Okay.
But you didn't have to look like Elvis to get in on the action. Thousands lined up today at post offices throughout the country to buy the Elvis stamp. Some waited in line for hours.
Elvis is my favorite one.
And he was just loved by millions, young and old.
Elvis collector Joe Marks says he understands the mania. He says Elvis is also gaining tremendous popularity in Japan, Germany, and England. And at the post office today, he was the first in line.
Elvis is alive for everybody, I guess. I guess he'll go on forever. Rock and mail for you, Elvis.
Rock and mail for you, Elvis. Nancy Williams, Fox News.
Elvis sightings are now reported all over the United States.
Well, the big day finally arrived for Elvis Presley fans around the country. The stamp honoring the king of rock and roll went on sale today on what would have been his 58th birthday. Presley's ex-wife and his daughter, together with thousands of other people, gathered in Memphis at midnight when the stamps officially went on sale. The Presleys say it's a fitting tribute.
What he contributed to our music and our culture was enormous and is worthy of the greatest respect and appreciation.
It's a great acknowledgement, and I really appreciate it. And I speak on behalf of him and my family and myself. Thank you.
Fireworks lit up the night skies over Graceland at the exact moment the stamps went on sale, but the rest of the country had to wait until noon today. Now, here in the Southland, demand for the new stamp was just as great, and so was the celebration, especially at the Nixon Library, where fans marked the King's birthday, Richard Nixon's birthday, and the debut of the stamp. Steve Lentz was there.
At the Nixon Library, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now, go, Dick, go. But don't you step on my blue suede stamp. These Yorba Linda people will do anything to get one of those stamps.
The stamp is the main reason.
That's why we're here, because it's
a little piece of history, something not necessarily for us, but for our children, in the hopes that, like everything else in America that's probably worth anything, later on the value will hopefully increase.
What are you going to do with your one Elvis stamp?
Probably collect them like everybody else, put them away, and then 10 years or 20, they won't be worth anymore. But, you know, at least you say you were there and you had them.
On the less serious side of Elvis, there is that sincerest form of flattery, imitation. At the Hollywood Post Office, Elvez and the Elvettes Serenade. No need to worry about an Elvis stamp shortage or odd and even rationing days. The post office printed 500 million likenesses. From today forward, you can lick the king, you can cancel the king, but you can't stamp the king into any one mold. Your Belinda, this isn't. In Hollyweird, Steve Lynch, Channel 5, News at 10.